انا سعيد طبعا ان انا بقدم الحاله دي النهارده في مؤتمر اسم الكلى لعين شمس. بشكر الدكتوره هويده الشناوي ودكتوره امين سرحان ودكتوره مها بحيري، وان شاء الله يكون مؤتمر موفق كده وتوزا بوينت. الحاله بتاعتنا النهارده هو بيشنت 45 years old male patient born and living in Cairo, Egypt. He is a farmer married with three offspring. Zhang is being 7 years old. He is ex-smoker, stopped smoking 1 year ago. He was a shisha smoker for 20 years. He presenting complaining of nausea, vomiting of 1 week duration. The patient's condition started 7 years ago with bilateral symmetrical, painless soft beating edema and the puffiness of the eyelids, which was more notable in the morning and resolved throughout the day. There was no associated oliguria or hematuria or dyspnea or somnia or other symptoms suggestive volume overload. The patient sought medical advice. Various investigations were done, including renal biopsy. Serum creatinine was 1.2 milligram per deciliter. Protein creatinine was 10 grams. Renal biopsy done 7 years ago, light microscopy showed 17 glomeruli. One of 17 glomeruli is globally sclerosed, and one of 17 glomeruli show periglomerular fibrosis. The rest of the glomeruli show diffuse moderate thickening of the capillary walls with a mild increase of the mesangial matrix. Renal tubules show vascular degeneration with mild focal atrophy. Interstitial tissue show aggregates of foam cells and sparse mononuclear inflammatory cells with mild fibrosis. Arterioles show mild to moderate thickening of zero walls. Electron microscopy confirming the above data also reveals thick glomerular basement membrane due to the large subepithelial electron dense deposits, some of which show resolution, and some mesangial deposits are also noted. Diffuse fusion of the epithelial cell food process is also noted, and the patient diagnosed membranous glomerulonephritis. Stage 3. The patient was diagnosed with a membranous glomerulonephritis and hypertension. He was administered steroids and 3 cycles of cyclophosphamide, then maintained on oral steroids and cyclosporine with regular follow-up of kidney functions. 4 months ago, the patient noted abdominal pain that was dull aching in nature, of insidious onset and gradual progressive course, not relieved by simple analgesia, and associated with nausea and occasional vomiting. He presented to our hospital where AKI and heavy proteinuria were found. COVID-19 infection was excluded via CT chest and PCR of nasopharyngeal swab. Serum creatinine was 7 milligram per deciliter and protein creatinine was 15 grams. Conservative management was implanted with follow-up of labs and renal biopsy was scheduled. But progressive and rapid worsening of kidney function was noted, and the patient was started IV pulse steroids. Further deterioration of kidney function was imminent, and ultimately hemodialysis was initiated. The patient underwent 3 sessions of hemodialysis. As regards the past history, the patient was diabetic, diabetes mellitus diagnosed 1.5 years ago on oral hypoglycemic drugs, hypertension diagnosed 7 years ago on verapamil and methylDopa, no history of previous surgeries or blood transfusion. As regards the family history, there was no family history for similar condition, renal impairment of nephritic syndrome. Drug history, patient was on Celebrate 20 milligram once per day, Neural 2 milligram per kilogram per day, Isoptin twice per day, Aldomet twice per day, and Dimicron 30 milligram once per day. On examination, the patient was conscious, alert, oriented, time, person, place, blood pressure was 150/90, pulse was 95 beats per minute regular, temperature was 36.9, saturation was 97 on room air, normal complexion, bilateral soft beating and painless beadal edema up to mid-thigh. On chest consultation, there was a bilateral equal air entry, normal vesicular breathing with no fine basal crepitation. The abdomen was lax, with no ascites or clinically palpable organomegaly. Cardiological auscultation shows normal heart sound with no murmurs and or pericardial rub. As regards the urine output, the patient 2 liters per day. As regards the laboratory investigation, البيز لاين لابس كرياتين واز 1.2 بان واز 18 صوديوم 136 بوتاسيوم 3.6 كالسيوم 8.8 فوسفورس 3.2 مغنيسيوم 2.2 البومين 3.3 التوتال كوليسترول 210 تريجلسرايد 180 اون ادميشن كرياتين واز 7 اند 1 واز 92 صوديوم 126 اند بوتاسيوم 3.7 كالسيوم واز 8.6 افتر ذا هيموداليسيس ستيشنز اند ستيرويدز الكرياتين واز 5.1 اند بان واز 52 صوديوم 141 بوتاسيوم 3.7 كالسيوم 7.5 فوسفورس 3.5 مغنيسيوم 1.8 البومين 2 يورين اناليسيس البيز لاين يورين اناليسيس شوينج وايت بلاد سيلز 527 ار بي سيز 224 نو البومين نو كوست اون ادميشن ذا يورين اناليسيس شوينج total white BCs 3 to 5 RBCs 20 to 25 albumin plus 2 24 urinary proteins the baseline was 210 milligram on admission 15.9 grams after pulse steroid there is no change the protein 24 urinary proteins was 15.1 As regards the CBC on admission, the total leukocyte count was for 14, hemoglobin 10.7, MCV 56, MCH 17.4, platelets 459. As regards the viral markers and the autoimmune markers, all are negative. The parathyroid hormone was 250. البلفي ابدومينال التراساوند ليفر واز افريج سايز ويز نو افريج سايز ويز نو هوموجينس ويز هوموجينس ايكو باترن اند سبين افريج سايز ويز هوموجينس ايكو باترن بوث كيدنيز واز افريج ان سايز ويز نورمال بانكيمال سيكنس اند ايكوجينيستي رينال بايوبسي لايت مايكروسكوبي شوينج 19 جلوميرولاي 4 اوت اوف 19 ار جلوبال سكليروز 2 اوت اوف 19 شوز ا سيجمنتال سكليروزيس 17 out of 19 show moderate diffuse thickening of capillary walls. 2 out of 19 show dilated capillaries with hyaline thrombi. Interstitial tissue shows moderate fibrosis and moderate infiltration by mononuclear inflammatory cells. Tibule show moderate atrophy and some are dilated with hyaline cast. Medium-sized arteries show moderate to moderate fibro-intimal thickening. Arteriole show thick walls and hyalinosis and narrow lamina. Immunohistochemistry IgG. 2-3 plus granular capillary wall staining, IgM or IgA, 1 plus mesangial, C3 negative, electron microscopy relieved intramembranous electron dense deposit, many of which show evidence of resolution. Subepithelial deposits are seen as well. Subendothelial widening of laminar area interna of glomerular basement membrane by flocculent material and fibrinogen tactoids. This slide showing sclerotic glomeruli and the hyaline thrombi. And at tubular atrophy, this slide showing congested glomerular capillaries and the hyaline thrombi. This hyaline thick wall arteriole and the interstitial inflammations. Slide showing thick wall displated capillary walls and the periglomerular fibrosis, tubular atrophy, interstitial fibrosis, thick wall displated capillary walls and the periglomerular fibrosis. This electron microscopy showing thick glomerular basement membranes by subepithelial and intramembranous deposits with evidence of resolution and subendothelial widening of flocculent material. And the renal biopsy revealed the diagnosis membranous glomerulonephritis, thrombomicroangiomas, mostly second to drugs, cyclosporine, and moderate chronic tubular interstitial nephritis. To summarize, 45 years old male patient with a history of primary membranous glomerulonephritis diagnosed 7 years ago. He first diagnosed with renal impairment 4 months ago with a serum creatinine 7 mg/dL. The patient presented with rapidly progressive renal failure and the biopsy showing membranous glomerulonephritis TMA positive drug induced. What is the next step in the management plan and role of plasma apheresis and rituximab? Thank you.